But who before that? How many people die not being able to go out and their liberties or whatnot. But this
is not so long ago.
And instead, what's happening is, with the war of attrition, right, we keep fighting the virus keeps fighting us, right? And we never win. The virus never wins either, but we don't win either. And so, that's really essentially what I'm grasping. And the mainstream media, what they're advocating in terms of opposing the again, we want something more. What are you different? Like, there isn't really anything else. And if you were to shutdown, the government shutdown, what are we going to get? It's not shutting up computers, right? But there's plenty of factors about that. Oh, this is essential system. Keep ourselves, the virus is still going to remain alive somewhere, in some part, somewhere. And eventually, as soon as it goes up again, you let the thing out of the hole again. There you go. Anyway. Back to the title of the stage. So we're going to politics. So why do I think that Biden has a better chance? Because he has the media answer to that one, training Trump as being lost on the coronavirus. And remember, a lot of people who are homes to support him, they'll go anti-divert, who are woke to support Trump, they might be turned off by this narrative that he's with coronavirus. Because remember, that he supposedly can be the subverted. He's a mean word for conservatives. That's all we care. People who get older are less adventurous. They want to have one hand in the question. So, that's all the case, by the way. But it also has to do with political initiatives and et cetera. The fact they have retirement accounts, they have savings, they have money, they try to practice, they want to practice with that. But anyway, so the people, they tend to be Trumpists, right? They tend to be conservative, but they might actually break away because of this. So, what do I have to say with regard to this? I would say it's still early, right? Now it's the end of July, maybe August, September, October, November. So we have about 3 months until the election. And 3 months might not be a lot, but in the day and age that we live in, it is a lot. And the people on that side are putting, I don't know exactly when they start. It's going to be a mail ballot. But, I don't know, the people on that side are putting until months, 2 months at least. And so a lot of things change. And there's a reasonable, possible argument made that in 2 months, this second wave will be over, and the world has gotten there. And they will react to other issues. I'm just going to actually be winning those issues. Because remember, people are not very consistent. They're not thought out. A lot of the things that they're based on is just emotional stuff. So these things, fluctuate. They could, the needle moves to the right, to the left. It doesn't say I'm not. For those people. Now, of course, there are people who are diehard, and they will never, ever, most people, they will never switch parties, or rarely switch parties, but there aren't as many of those people. The ones who actually do determine the election outcome are the ones in the middle, who are more susceptible to be picked off by the side based on the current government. And then other governments may rise, but we don't know why that's going to be the case in the 3 months. So basically, overall, they say that Trump still has a good chance of winning. Now, regarding the polls, show I know, but I don't trust those as much as polls of Trump, meaning that if polls show that Biden's winning in a particular state, by the way, only three states matter, okay? Some states really know. They're like me in the back, but nobody cares about them. Don't tell me that Biden is winning the polls in New York and California, okay? That's just not, I don't need it. That doesn't matter for the election, for the purpose. And if California and New York is going to go they go to Democrat. What really matters is the question is, who is winning a poll in three states? And to what extent do we trust the polls? When it seems the polls were awfully wrong. And the question is, are they better now? And there's no evidence to believe that they are. The same Trump poll that they missed, for whatever reason, they probably didn't miss it enough. So they're still going to be off by about, I don't know the exact number, but it's 3 to 5 cents. It's going to be off by that number. In the poll. Whatever the poll tells you, it's given the 5 cents for Trump. You have to analyze it. You don't analyze it this way, then you're a fool. A fool doesn't have a fool if somebody doesn't learn everything. That's what you are. If you don't do that, the same result. They have not, the people that have not changed anything. You ask them, what has changed in response to getting the polls wrong? That's what they see. They want to know how you're not a pandemic, right? They haven't learned anything. But we should adjust based on that and say that it's traditional 100%. So if the poll tells you that I'm winning in a single state by 50%, yes, I'm winning in trouble. And if he's winning by 10%, yes, I'm winning in trouble. If he's winning by 7%, not really. That is within the margin of error. 1% at all. If it's winning, if it's winning by 11% of the base, that is a strong case. Money and bank. Believe me. Mark my words. And then come back in 4 months and see if I was right. If Biden's winning, sorry, that's what's going here. If Biden's winning by mere 5% in a swing state, less than 5%, Trump is winning. So the bottom line is like this. The bottom line is right now, I mean, the polls are swing states are not even more than 5%. So why is someone learning? But again, like I said, this is for watching, and have a good day.